For me, the brain defines the character of a person. When we see people with neurological disorders, one can immediately recognize how severe these changes can be. This was always fascinating for me to find out more about how these disorders develop, how they progress, and also, of course, to help the patient not suffering from these disorders. My name is Michel Mittelbronn. I'm a professor in neuropathology. I am the head of the Multidisciplinary Center of Neuropathology in Luxembourg and the head of pathology at the Laboratoire National de Santé. My aim is to develop better diagnostic and treatment strategies for neurodegenerative disorders and brain tumors.
Brain specialist Professor Michel Mittelbronn came to Luxembourg in 2017 with a grant from the PEARL program of the Luxembourg National Research Fund. Diseases of the brain are among the most complex neurological disorders of all and are especially difficult to diagnose and treat. Often, the exact disease can only be identified after death. The changes become clear when comparing with a healthy donor brain.
You see in the midbrain that the substantia nigra, this is the affected area in Parkinson's brains, is gray dark, and this is due to the fact that these neurons contain a pigment, the dark pigment, which is called neuromelanin. When the disease of Parkinson's progresses here, then you see that this area becomes pale or almost white because these neurons are dying and therefore the pigment gets lost. And this is the end stage in Parkinson's disease.
Parkinson's disease has long been a focus of research at the Luxembourg Center for Systems Biomedicine. Many important new discoveries have already been made here regarding the onset and course of the disease. Now, the Institute of the University of Luxembourg is expanding its expertise into the field of neuropathology. The brain is not only made of neurons. So, how do diseases affect other cells of the brain? Michel Mittelbronn and his researchers are exploring this question in mouse models, using tissue samples from the brains of mice. Different cell types are labeled in special preparations. Each cell type then shows up in a different color under the fluorescence microscope. Through studies like these, the researchers have already shown, for example, that immune cells are also implicated in Parkinson's disease. They react strongly to the disease-specific accumulation of a certain protein in the affected area of the brain.
These cells proliferate, they become bigger, they have a change in morphology, and we think that they do additional harm to the brain. And our strategy now is to try to modify these immune cells to inhibit or to slow down, at least in neurodegenerative disorders.
So far, existing therapies for Parkinson's disease only serve to slow down the decline of afflicted neurons or to alleviate symptoms. Accordingly, there is urgent need for new therapeutic approaches that will combat the disease more effectively. At the Luxembourg Institute of Health, the experts under Michel Mittelbronn's lead focus on research in malignant brain tumours. What are the processes that decide whether a tumour will grow into a compact lump or will spread as ultra-fine branches deep into the brain where it's almost impossible to treat? And how exactly do cancer cells from primary tumours in remote parts of the body spread through the bloodstream to form metastases in the brain? The researchers can study such fundamental relationships in cell cultures in the laboratory. However, to corroborate basic research findings in neuroscience, human tissue specimens are essential. For this reason, Michel Mittelbronn, together with his team and collaboration partners, are going to establish a brain bank in Luxembourg.
If it's corroborated in the human tissue, then we can maybe translate it into clinical application at the end, meaning as a diagnostic marker, for example, or in the long term as a target for treatment. And we are, of course, happy about every single brain donor that really helps us to bring our basic research finding into clinical applications at the end.
Besides conducting research and developing better diagnostic methods, Michel Mittelbronn feels the results of his work should provide an immediate benefit to patients. Patients can come to him directly for detailed consultation about their pathological diagnoses. This patient was able to have a benign tumor successfully removed.
The PEARL Chair really guarantees to fill this gap for diagnostic research and teaching in neuropathology. Before, specimens were sent abroad, so Luxembourg basically had a drain of all neurosurgical specimens. And this is a pity, because on the one hand you have really good basic research, you have really good clinical research or clinical structures, but neuropathology was really the missing link. And that's why the Luxembourg research landscape decided to establish this position, and I think it was a very good decision, because we now really have a lot of interaction with clinicians, with basic researchers, and my group is somehow at the interface between diagnostics, research, teaching.
With funding from the Luxembourg National Research Fund, Michel Mittelbronn and his colleagues are working to increase and improve neuropathological research and diagnosis in Luxembourg. It's a good example of the country's strategy to help leading experts apply their skills across multiple institutions and thus create strong synergies between research and practice.